Hey, everybody, thanks for checking out another bonus episode of The New Marketing Show. You know, I just had something pretty frustrating happen. We move things to reels, and trying to get a clear, concise point across in 30 seconds is really difficult. So bear with us as we flesh this out. But today, people of the internet, I want to talk to you about a results bias. So what is results bias? Results bias is you thinking that based on the result that you got, let's say a positive result, that you did everything right in order to achieve that result. It's flawed thinking because a lot of times what happens is you make wrong decisions, things don't fall your way, things out of your control happen, your process is maybe jacked or broke, but you still get your desired outcome. It's dangerous when this happens. Let me tell you why. It's dangerous when this happens because what happens is you're going to rely on that, you know, in your mental muscles or whatever you want to call it. You know, you're going to rely on that on recall to do X, Y, and Z in order to achieve what you want to. So I think that more importantly is when you go ahead and you do something and you get the wrong result, look back at your process and say, did we do everything right? We did this right. We did this right. Oh, maybe we did this wrong. Let's change that. And maybe that would then influence the outcome. Or did you do this wrong, this wrong, this wrong, but still get the right result? See, what happens is, you know, in a lot of cases is a lot of times people and businesses and marketing and everything is successful for no rhyme or reason. And they get the proper result that they want, although they did everything wrong. And, you know, I would always say, you know, I know a bunch of people who are sort of successful despite themselves, you know, meaning like they get in the way, they do everything wrong, but still somehow, you know, things turn out okay. So what I would encourage you to do and what we do at Trinity and what we're going to keep doing more of at Trinity is when we analyze and we talk about the results of something that happens, rather than just talking about the results and the metric of the results, we talk about the process and how did we get to that result? Did we do everything right, but the results still turned out wrong? Okay, what can we review, refine, repeat? Did we do everything okay and the result was okay? See, in my mind, that would be an okay correlation because, you know, there's a correlation between, you know, the execution and the result. So there's just a lot of times, you know, you have to go back and you have to evaluate your process. You have to evaluate, in marketing terms, you have to evaluate your strategy. You have to evaluate your execution to see where you are with the result. Now, look, sometimes you're going to be successful despite yourself. And that's a good thing. But more times than not, it doesn't mean that it's the right thing to do. So, you know, just because something works out, you know, all's well that ends well type of thing, just because everything is cool like that in the end with the outcome, it doesn't mean that it's always going to be that way. And it doesn't mean that your process and what you did led you to that result. I know, confusing, complicated shit, but I'm going to start talking more about biases. I'm really, you know, getting into the psychology of decision making and processes. And I'm reading a great book called The Inside Game by Keith Law. And it's about decisions and process making. And they use baseball as a conduit. And I'm a huge baseball fan. So it definitely makes it easier for me to digest. So I'm going to keep talking about this stuff. Thank you so much for bearing with me. Thank you so much for listening. Thank you so much for supporting Trinity Web Media. I hope everybody is still safe and being cautious and take care of themselves out there here in 2021. And we'll talk to you soon.